Two battles with AI, Joshua 7 and 8. God had given the Israelites instructions about the treasures they found in Jericho. The gold, silver, brass, and iron. Everything was to go into the treasury of the Lord. It all belonged to Him. No one was to take anything for himself. Everyone obeyed. Everyone except a man named Achan. He took a beautiful coat and some silver and gold for himself. He hid them in a hole in the ground under his tent where no one would see them. But God saw Achan's sin and was angry with him. There would be serious consequences for Israel and for Achan's family. In preparation for Israel's next attack, Joshua sent spies to Ai. The spies returned with a good report. "Don't take the entire army to Ai," the spies reported to Joshua. "It's a small city, and there aren't many people living there. 2,000 or 3,000 men should do the job just fine." About 3,000 soldiers marched to Ai. They expected to win the battle. Instead, 36 Israelites died as the army of Ai chased the Israelites away. When the people of Israel heard what had happened, they were alarmed. How could this happen? God had just helped them defeat Jericho, a very strong city. How could they have lost to little Ai? To show his sadness, Joshua tore his clothes and put dust on his head. He bowed before the ark of the Lord until evening. Joshua questioned God, "O Lord God, why did you bring us across the Jordan River if you were going to let us be destroyed? What can I say now that Israel has been chased by its enemies? When our enemies hear about this, they'll surround us and kill us. Then what will become of your great name?" God said to Joshua, "Get up. Why are you on your face? Israel has sinned. They have disobeyed my command. Someone has taken treasures from Jericho and hid them among his things. That is why Israel cannot stand before their enemies. I refuse to help Israel until they have destroyed the treasures I told them not to take." God told Joshua to separate the Israelites by tribe, family, household, and person. God promised to show Joshua who had sinned. He further commanded that the person responsible be burned to death along with everything he owned. Early the next morning, Joshua organized the Israelites by tribe. God pointed out the tribe of Judah. From Judah, God selected the Zerahites and then the Zabdi family. Joshua went to every person in Zabdi's family until God showed him Achan. Joshua spoke to Achan, "Let God have the glory and tell me what you have done." Achan confessed, "I have sinned against the Lord God. When I was in Jericho, I found a beautiful coat, 200 shekels of silver, and a bar of gold. When I saw them, I wanted them. I stole them and buried them under my tent." Joshua sent messengers to Achan's tent, and they found the stolen treasures hidden there. The messengers brought the treasures to Joshua, who laid them out before God. Now Joshua had to obey God's command. He took Achan, the coat, the silver, the gold, his sons and daughters, his animals, even his tent, and everything else he owned, and brought them to a place called the Valley of Achor. "Why did you do this?" Joshua asked. "Why have you brought trouble on us? Now God will bring trouble on you." The Israelites stoned Achan and his family. Then they set fire to everything and put a large pile of stones over whatever was left. God was no longer angry with the people of Israel. He told Joshua to fight against Ai. God promised that he would give Israel victory. He told Joshua to kill Ai's king and its people. But this time God said the Israelites could take treasures from the city. Joshua divided his army so he could ambush the city of Ai. After nightfall, Joshua sent 30,000 men to sneak behind the city. The rest stayed with Joshua. In the morning, the men with Joshua attacked the city and then pretended to run away. Ai's army chased after them and left their city unprotected. When Joshua gave the signal, the men hiding behind the city ran inside and set it on fire. The men of Ai looked back and saw their city inflamed, but there was nothing they could do. Joshua's fleeing army turned on them and attacked them. God gave Israel a great victory. The Israelites had learned to respect God and to take His command seriously. God will not ask us to fight armies like He asked the Israelites to do. That is not part of His plan for us today. But He does want us to respect Him and obey His commands. When we do, we show our love for God.